and welcome to Critical Strike, episode 51. I'm Josh Bicknell, and here with me is Bill Haberman.
Hello.
And Mr. Pete Dodd.
Hi.
Knights in white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send.
Awesome.
Nice intro, Pete.
Yay.
Yay, you're on the Critical Strike podcast.
That is a first.
It is. I'm excited.
Well, I wouldn't be too excited.
I'm very fucking excited. Apparently, well, I'm swearing about it.
It's really hard to get you on here, though, because like you work weekends.
Yeah, I'm at work right now. I'm actually getting paid good money to be on this podcast.
Right. And it's not by me.
No.
And play video games, which we're doing as well.
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, one thing that we're going to do is we're going to be playing White Knight Chronicles and just basically shooting the shit about it. It's going to be like an awkward hour of talking about White Knight Chronicles.
If you don't think you'll like this game, good luck with the podcast.
Basically. And you will like this game because I told you you will.
It's a fantastic game.
It is. And one thing I wanted to go into before we really started going into the adventures is this game got destroyed in fucking reviews.
Yeah, it did.
Like, I actually just looked at the IGN review, and it was like a 5.1.
Yeah.
And I was like, are you serious?
It's almost insulting. It's kind of like too human. It was a bad game, but I don't think it was as bad as everyone made it out to be. And this is pretty similar.
Yeah.
Everybody Except this was game's
like,
fun.
And also, everybody was like, oh, it looks like crap and all this other stuff, and really, it does not look like crap at all.
Yeah, I don't understand that complaint in the slightest.
All right, I just made a quest, boys.
Sweet. But we're also going to be playing the game.
Yeah, well, I said that. It's going to be an awkward hour of playing and talking about the game.
I didn't think you emphasized it enough, Josh.
It is an awkward hour of playing and talking about the game.
Right on.
But even and people who like it have complained about the graphics, which is weird. It's not just, you know, like, IGN hated every single aspect of the game.
And I don't get why people are really shitting on the graphics. Like, when I talked to Billy the other day about it, the comparison I used was, look at Gears of War, right? That game was praised for how it looked because it was a first-generation game, and it looked really good, but the reasoning to it was you're in a small corridor and they can fit a lot more to it.
Mm-hmm.
But then, look at this. Like, we're in a quest right now and the map is huge.
Yeah.
So, it just, for the size of the scale that we're doing, it looks really good.
And there's more than just two shades of brown coloring everything.
Like
there is in Gears of War.
Well, it's like we were saying, there's not enough games that have, like, a whole color palette, and this thing kind of runs the gamut. It's all over the place.
Right.
Desert brown to rainbows and greens, and it's kind of nice to look at for once.
Don't forget to talk to the guy this time.
Oh.
Yeah, when you start a quest online, you have to talk to the guy to get your objective, and I seem to be the only one to do that.
Hey, what do you know? Josh is running off by himself. That's new.
What are you talking about?
Well, we are
a
little bit overpowered for this.
Yeah, of the quests we have to do over to get our guild rank up before we can go into the other ones. Because, like, you and I are, what, guild rank number 2?
I'm still number 1. So. I've been having online problems, which I may continue to have.
Well, you're at work.
Yeah, I am, but I had the same problem. I worked last night also, and I decided to play with some randoms, and I got disconnected in the same exact way that I did when I was home.
Okay.
So
your internet followed you,
is what you're telling me. I bring my internet with me when I travel across state lines.
He has a carrying case.
I wanted to punch you out that day. I hate it when people go, my internet is really messed up right now.
You know, that's actually the type of thing that typically would annoy me also, but it doesn't. So I think that's why I kept saying it, because it was almost like I was annoying myself by saying it to you over and over again.
Oh, I was so mad.
I like that I don't even have to do anything. I just follow Josh around and he one hits everything.
Oh, dude, I'm hitting stuff for like 113 damage. Look at that. Uh-huh.
I'm just hanging out.
I'm only hitting for 68, but I have this crappy one-hander. I'm 21. Huh. Yeah, don't go short swords, everybody. It's boring.
Short swords is really good later on, and that's actually one thing I wanted to say. Like, the way that the skills are set up, like, you can kind of damn yourself early on in the game and not even know it.
Yeah.
Well, I went all short sword thus far. Like, I have almost all of those skills, but not knowing what Pete just said.
Right.
You live and you learn.
And one thing that you also didn't know was that when you're... One of your biggest complaints is actually the action timer.
Mm-hmm.
And the action timer is kind of like a hybrid of the active time battle from like Final Fantasy VI and up.
Yeah.
Which brings me to my statement that this game, one thing I don't understand why people don't like it, it's a hybrid of Final Fantasy XII, Monster Hunter, you know, Final Fantasy XI, all these games. There's no reason why people shouldn't like it. It has a great like molding of different games to it. Mm-hmm. But for some reason, you just didn't like the action, the time thing that they have for the battles.
It's not my favorite, but I think, you know, I'm not a big JRPG fan like you are. Like, I'm kind of new to this world. And the fact that I'm still playing it and enjoying it, like, right now, does say something about the game, you know what I mean? Because there's been plenty of RPGs where I pick up for half an hour, kind of like the game challenge I had with you, and I'll never go back, but...
You're not going to play that again?
Probably not.
What? No, I'm still playing KOTOR.
I will. Maybe.
Terrible.
No, there's just too many things going on. I'll pick it up again at some point, probably in the summer.
Right.
But,
right on.
I mean, even for somebody like me who doesn't generally care for this type of game, I'm still playing. I think I'm down, what, like 10 hours now? Which is more than I've played Darksiders.
Which isn't saying much, but...
No, I'm having fun with that game. It's just, but I keep coming back to this because I don't want to fall that far behind you guys, and I'm already starting to slip.
Well, the nice thing about that though is like, it'll look like you're not catching up when we play online, mm-hmm. but you are getting more experience than we are.
Sure.
Yeah.
Especially since I don't have to hit anything because I'm following you around.
Yeah, and it keeps you from. It does keep you from power leveling somebody through like Borderlands let you.
Yeah, which. But, it's crazy how quickly you can catch up to somebody in that game.
Yeah, like, see, I just earned 9 experience from that.
Sucks for you, buddy.
I know, I'm one-shotting everything and you're getting all my experience.
Uh-huh.
But that's pretty cool, though. And one thing I did like, though, is that it carries on through your single player. Like, my character is now 22 in my single player.
And the best option of the game, which every game should have after this, is the auto-run button. Wonderful.
Oh, no shit, dude.
Yeah.
It is amazingly awesome. Like, I was playing Borderlands earlier today, and I just kept wishing that same option existed.
I don't really think of many other RPGs that have that, now that I think about it.
It's always been MMOs, you know, like...
World of Warcraft.
World of Warcraft has it, and I think EverQuest had it. It's been a long time since I played that. But that was after I played World of Warcraft for about 3 years straight, like... 18 hours a day when I started playing console games again, even shooters, I was like, where's the auto run button? You just get so used to it. And this is really the first console game to have it.
It's okay, guys. I'm just sleeping by a tree. Don't worry about me.
Yeah, I saw that. You got put to sleep.
Thanks, bud.
That's great. Don't worry, I completed the quest.
We should maybe like mention how like the online works, because it is kind of cool compared to a lot of games out there.
Actually, the online's really slick.
Yeah.
I'm like really impressed.
You go on to GeoNet, and that's one thing too. Like, none of the reviewers talked about the online at all. Like, none of them mentioned it.
Yeah.
If they did, they said we didn't try it.
Right. Which is bullshit, because what people don't realize about this game, there's more to it than the single player story. There is a lot of components to this game, like your Georama, GeoNet, synthesizing your own weapons, and binding your weapons, and there's a lot to this game, and the online component is probably like the biggest attraction for me.
I almost wish they had just concentrated on the online portion.
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, I mean, the single player is fine and all, but I have much more fun playing with you guys.
Here comes the long save period.
One complaint I will give people is how long it takes to save.
Yeah, but the online component, dude, is you go on GeoNet and you're greeted there with like your own personal social network webpage. And from there you can add all your friends and so forth. There's a message board that thousands of people are on. Like, I was scrolling through it, and by far my favorite thread that is on there is there any furries out there?
Yeah, the furry thread is great. I read that whole thing. It was like 400 posts long.
Did you really?
I don't know what got into me. I went back to the beginning, and the next thing I knew, like 45 minutes had passed, and I'd read 500 messages of people talking about being furries.
Wow.
So now you're into furries?
Yeah. Well, what I kind of figured out from that was I think half the people were kidding, and I think the other half were like pimply-faced teenagers that aren't necessarily furries, but if it would get them laid, they would be. You know, so they're just like, oh, cool, I get to, you know, talk sexual, so I can pretend.
Nice. But, ah, man, the online message board is just great, though, because, like, you can go on, and one thing that Billy said is even if, like, I'm not here or Mick's not on and Pete's not here, he can go on there, make a post, and find the game pretty quickly.
Exactly.
All right, it's made another quest.
Cool.
But it's just, I think the online is really slick, and I would love to see more games do something like this.
Well, just the online boards alone. It's just, that's my favorite part about it.
It gives you that real social aspect of a game like this, like something that Monster Hunter has always been trying to get.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with the Dot Hack animes.
A little bit. That seems like ultra hardcore, though.
Well, the Dot Hack animes are based off of playing in an MMO. It's characters in an MMO world. And this is basically, like, beyond being in virtual reality, this is Dot Hack, in a way.
Yeah, I'm not familiar. I mean, I remember when the games came out, I never played them, though.
I never played them either on the PS2.
Yeah.
It's collectibles over here.
Yeah, I tried to do that, and I couldn't get it to work. Oh, here we go.
No, you get out of here.
This is my stuff.
Oh, my God, you guys are all taking my little white flowers.
My Georama sells little white flowers now. I got it upgraded.
Yeah, that's one thing, too. Like, the Georama is just fun.
Yeah.
Like, I haven't even figured out where that's set up. So, that's, like, where?
The same way that you go into the online. Like, when you go to one of the save points,
mm-hmm.
It's right there.
Right on.
Yeah, you go to a save point, go to GeoNet, and then down at the bottom it says visit Georama or edit Georama.
And then it kind of just has the, like, the dark cloud vibe where you start building up a little village and they start leveling up as far as stuff they make and sell and all that.
Yeah.
Yep.
Cool.
And you can upload your Georama so people can come and buy things from your store online and, you know, kind of give you a little bit of cash. Because apparently people seem to be having problems with cash in this game.
Yeah. I've been reading that. Another cool thing, too, that goes along with the message boards is that you can have your own sort of personal blog, which at first I was like, this is for sort of like hyper geeks who want to write, like, today I went into the forest and I found blah, blah, blah. But a lot of people are using it for guides. Like this... Like, this one guy's like, since everything on the message board is so fluid and threads get buried in a day or two, this guy was like, hey, if you ever want to know how to farm this certain element, you know, like, check out my homepage. I have a guide for it. So a lot of people have started doing that.
I haven't seen that.
So it's cool. It's almost like, in the same way that, or not the same way, but in how Demon Souls had, built into it. This kind of does too.
I wish Demon's Souls Online played like this, because we'd probably still be playing that game if we could all get together like this.
Yeah, the way Demon's Souls did it was just weird. Like, you had to, one person had to be alive, and the other one had to be dead, and then you summoned each other.
Yeah, too much for me.
It was weird. I never played that online at all.
Yeah, me neither. I wanted to get invaded and have someone kill me, and that never happened.
Well, you had to go on at, like, certain times.
I still never figured out the whole white and black nonsense with that game.
Well, white meant that the monsters were easier to kill and you're less likely to be invaded, and black meant that you were going to be invaded.
Huh.
It's not too hard to figure out.
It is for this guy.
you with this game, and the weird questions that you're asking me all the time.
Well, I just ask you those because it's funny because I like to annoy you. Much like the Final Fantasy questions I would ask you.
But it doesn't annoy me.
Josh, where was the save point in the third city of Fangalala?
It's been like, I haven't played that game in X amount of years.
You
I don't remember.
You are a dirty liar.
I haven't played it in a long time.
You're a fucking liar.
Ooh, another thing over here. Nobody understood this stuff here. That what I'm doing right now is where you'll find like a crack in the rock and you can start picking up items out of it.
Oh, my character finds crack rocks.
Well, I'm not even gonna...
That's probably best.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. You guys are higher and you've played farther into the single player. Does, like, the actual loot become a little bit more frequent as far as things besides pebbles and insect shells? Like, do you find swords and shields?
Yes. Yeah.
It does become more frequent.
Mm-hmm.
Because like that was, like, the thing I keep looking at. Like, if it was, like, Sacred, where you're constantly changing things and finding weapons and armor, I'd be a lot more interested, I think.
Well, the gear that Pete is wearing right now is stuff that he got from questing.
Yeah.
And sexy.
And I've gotten a couple of spears and swords from it.
Yeah, the section I was just in, which is, like, this mountainous region, I got, like, 3 upgrades for this character and a couple upgrades for my party members. Just in the one section that took like 45 minutes to beat.
But unfortunately, what I'm seeing is the gear that you're getting off of these chests or monsters is stuff that you can buy in the store.
Yeah. Yeah, when I got this mace, I was really excited because I hadn't seen a mace anywhere. And then when I got to that huge town, the first thing that the weapons guy sold was a mace. And I was like, oh, damn it.
Right,
I thought I had something rare.
As your Georama progresses, that's actually where you get your items.
Yeah.
Like, you can get special gear pieces. Oh, I'll heal you, Billy.
Cool.
That's one thing I didn't understand, too, though, is, like, you had to buy the quest. I never...
That was a little confusing, because I think I only... When Pete and I tried to play the other night, we only had, like, 2 that we could do, which seems a little funny.
Yeah, and each town that you go to ends up having more.
Mm-hmm.
Right on.
So, like, if you go back to the first town, it won't have, like, the ones that I got in the town that I was just in.
Mm.
So, like, it kind of drives you to play the single player for the online element.
Yeah. It makes the towns sort of exciting, too, in that when you get to a town, like, one, the shops actually do have good stuff, because there's so many RPGs where the shops just have crap. Mm-hmm. 2, if you're building a Georama, you... Every town has people you can recruit to come live in your Georama. And then 3, you can buy new quests in each town. So it's like getting to a town actually is, you're like, all right, it opens up a bunch of content for you.
And the town that I just got to was like, wow, that's actually really cool. Like, I don't know if I want to spoil it.
I'm not worried about it.
Well, for others. All right, spoilers. The town that I'm at right now is like a gigantic walking beast where they built a town on top of its back.
Yeah, that's where I am too. It's awesome.
Where the hell are you guys?
I don't know. I'm following Billy for some reason.
Oh, really? You took off running and wondering where we're at. Hmm. That's new.
Look, I don't need anybody. I'm like my own team.
I know, but I need to stay by you so I can collect XP. No, we're right behind you.
I have no idea what we're doing in this quest. I'm just kind of...
My goal is to follow Josh around. It's not even worth me pulling out my sword. As soon as I do, the shit's already dead, and I just put it away.
Well, right now I'm asleep, so you guys
better
do something. Hey, you
said 23. Nezero.
Yeah, oh, that's another thing that really annoyed me about this game. The Japanese filters that they have when you go to name your character for the online. I couldn't use Nezero, what I normally use, because Uro in Japan means... perverted. So, yeah, that's why you pose next to me.
Yeah, I just did a karate pose to your face.
So I couldn't use Nezero. I had to be Nezero, which is kind of weird. Our objective's over here.
Yeah, it's kind of like a drunk guy saying your name.
In a way, yeah.
That's what it seems like to me.
I liken it to when Billy says my name.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, he's typically a drunk guy.
There you go.
He's that guy.
Mm-hmm.
That's the awkward hour.
I like creating names like that. It's entertaining, so when they say them in the story, it always is funnier to me.
me and that guy will be going west to Albana. So how far are you in the single player, Billy?
I just got to the desert, if that, it's probably not very far, but I just had that wonderful battle, which I don't know if we should or shouldn't spoil, right before that, so, yeah, right up here is where I had that, so we're in those caves, so, yeah, I just walked through here, and then that's where I saved last night.
Okay. Yeah, I have no idea what's gonna happen at this point, because I haven't done this quest online yet. I'm totally expecting, like, a big bear to come down and eat you and molest Pete, because he's a midget. The character creating in this is so weird. It's so bad, actually.
It's not the best, but it's, you know, Pete and I tried and made something original, and you just, like, selected most generic Japanese tall guy.
No way.
Oh man, I might actually have to do something here, huh?
This is my Cloud Strife sword. Don't attack the one that I'm attacking. I want to try this combo.
Figures they gang up on my character first.
I can't use that combo in here, god damn it.
And I love the AoE spells.
I only have one of them. I haven't really tried it. Let me try one right now. Wow, that's actually... Wow.
Yeah.
What you the just hell took out like six of them.
Yeah, I went pretty far into the elemental magic tree once I got bored with small swords.
Huh. Well, that's one thing that I do like, though. Even though like you kind of damn yourself with the characters that you select early on, or with the skills that you select, there's always room for more. Like, your character never, like, runs out of space. You can keep going.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you can go into elemental if you want. Like, my character has pretty much maxed out longswords. I think there's one skill I need to get. Get away from there, Billy. It's mine.
It's my stuff.
No way!
You guys do the work while I forage.
Yeah, and well, I never made the point that I wanted to. The last time we were talking about this stuff is... Like, Mick especially didn't understand why I keep getting rocks and pebbles and stuff. And
it puts I don't it in understand my... it yet.
Well, what it does is when you go to a vendor,
mm-hmm.
you have the option to enchant your items.
Sure.
And
I've
when
seen
you
that.
When you do that, these are like the reagents that you use.
Rocks?
Yeah. Well,
some of them are for building. When you go to your Georama, you build parts with other stuff too.
I have no idea if this is where we need to go. I'm assuming it isn't. Nope.
Like, for instance, the basic house you build uses a lot of the copper ore that we just picked up.
Right.
Right on.
So there's a lot, like, to what you're picking up.
Yeah, there's no garbage loot in the game. Everything is either equipment or is a reagent for something or other.
Which is pretty awesome.
Yeah, it is.
Like, every Final Fantasy game I have, like, I end up with a inventory of useless crap that you just pick up along the way.
Well, is there a cap on inventory? I have liked that I haven't noticed anything like that. I just keep everything I get.
Each character has a cap, but I think, like, in your item inventory or your equipment storage, there isn't.
Hmm.
But, like, I think the character can only hold, like, 20 items each.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know where I'm going.
Yeah,
right
now. Reagents you can carry unlimited amounts, but like gear and weapons and stuff, you can only carry 20 of.
Go auto run.
Yeah, auto run is a great option.
This kid's stuck on the door. Oh, there he goes.
It seems like a game though. If people play, if you were to play like a lot of MMOs, It seems like a game that you should at least give a try to.
Oh, wow, I might need you guys here.
You're on your own, buddy. I'm hitting the guy in the back.
Oh, there's a troll here. Fuck it. I'll take it alone. I don't need you guys.
Well, that's one of those things in the single player. You always have the oh, crap. I'm about to die. Run, dude.
I've yet to die in this game.
Aren't you fancy?
Oh, wow. You are about to die.
There we go.
Totally did a three-hit combo on that troll.
In the single player, you have the guy that can turn into a giant mech and just kind of basically destroy anything that screws with him. And it's...
Oh, the White Knight?
Yeah.
Well... I tend to not use it.
Really?
Because it kind of feels like cheating to me.
It kind of is.
Dude, you might want to heal yourself.
I'm working on it, dude.
Where are you?
I'm way back.
I only use the White Knight when I'm fighting something huge. I don't ever use it for normal stuff.
I used it against the Dark Knight, obviously, because you had to.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
But otherwise, I really haven't. And I kind of wish they had it online. Like, in later levels, you can unlock a White Knight or, you know, a Dark Knight for your online character. But it doesn't, from what I'm seeing, like, you really don't get that.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a shame. I mean, if I can, if we had to face this huge boss online, like a World of Warcraft type raid, then, like, you could be the tank and then I'm the healer and so forth. But it doesn't, it just kind of seems like it's everybody for himself. Which is kind of a missed opportunity to me.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with you. It in that way, it feels more like PSO or Monster Hunter instead of an MMO where everyone sort of truly has a role.
But, I mean, we're only doing, like, guild level 2 quests right now. I don't know how it is later on.
Yeah, it's true.
I got put to sleep again. Why is it always me?
So you get what for you running ahead. Every...
The game's finally punishing you.
I wasn't running ahead this time.
Whatever.
Oh, nice. The midget's asleep now.
I hate that my attacks are only like 19.
Well, you shouldn't be such a sissy.
Well, I went short sword. It seemed like in most games, that's just kind of your all-around you'll be okay class. And this game, not so much.
Oh, it is. But right now you're using a really weak item. I mean, your attacks are faster than mine and Pete's.
I haven't even found a second sword I can buy. I'm still dealing with the one I've had from the very beginning of the game.
Yeah, you're still early, though. I mean, it starts opening up for you. Pretty much in the deserts where it starts, the loot becomes much more...
prevalent?
Yeah. That's a good word.
Yeah. There's a troll down there. I have no idea where we're going. I know we have to collect these kids.
Hey, more trolls. Sweet. Stand back and watch Josh handle that.
What level are you, Pete?
21.
Oh yeah, that's not bad.
How many hours have you guys played this thus far to get that to that point?
I think there's a 20-hour trophy.
And no, I don't have there's that not. Yet.
Okay.
I am at my save that I loaded up today was at 19 hours and 56 minutes.
I haven't checked how many I have.
But a lot of that has been
Gioramaing.
And like I'll work on my Giorama and then I'll sort of just leave the game running and like go play Farmville on Facebook.
Oh no, you started that.
Oh Pete.
Oh dude.
It's like Harvest Moon, but not as charming. No.
Dude, my combo just did 229 damage. So really, Farmville?
Yeah. I don't know why. I can't justify it.
I'm trying to get away from Farmville and Facebook and all that stuff. It's like, every time I go on Facebook, I have like 60 fucking requests or something like that.
Yeah, I decided that I wanted to try it, and then I couldn't get it to work at all, and I was like, what the hell is going on? And then I realized that I'd blocked it, because I was so sick of people sending me Farmville requests.
I blocked it like that childhood priest incident.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, and it was actually Billy, not a priest.
It's not my fault I'm into that stuff, man.
I totally killed that troll. You guys did nothing.
I'm sure you did.
I got a giant shank.
Did you?
Yeah, it's this giant shank set to item storage.
You put me to sleep again.
I'm still have not mastered the combo hitting the buttons at the exact time. I'm getting better, but I'm by no means proficient at it.
And that's another thing. Like this game, kind of like how we mentioned Demon Souls earlier, doesn't really tell you what you need to do
in any way.
And it doesn't it doesn't really give you any instructions at all, which is kind of bad. But at the same point, I like it because I'm a RPG purist and. This is stuff that I kind of already know.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, it doesn't tell you short swords are going to be faster than the heavier weapon, but a little bit weaker. It doesn't tell you, you know, that your combos will be doing a little bit more damage if you don't spam the button, but you time it correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of a shame. Nobody really knew that. I read it online, and I saw somebody's statistics of them proving that if you time your combo, you get more damage. And I've seen it. Like, if I slam it, like, I've been getting, like, 100 damage combos. But if I didn't, then I'm getting, like, 150 to 170 damage. Which is quite
deep. I wish the combo system was a little bit refined. A little bit slicker.
What do you mean?
It seems like it's kind of a pain in the ass.
What, going in and selecting what skills you want?
Well, I mean, like, when I save a combo, I wish it was just saved on my game save, so if I do have another player with that weapon, it would just be able to just load that. I don't like that I have to do it for every character.
But like Pete mentioned on your show, your average JRPG person isn't going to make all their characters the same fucking skills.
I know, and I've kind of varied that, but like you said, once you kind of max something out, you're going to try something. So like, when it comes to the magic, you have a couple guys that both have learned some of that stuff.
Why but that's with your character, not with all of them. Like, a lot of them can't learn a bunch of other skills. Yours can.
Yeah, maybe.
Like, there's, Leonard can't use certain skills. Like, I don't think he can use bows. A couple of them can't use long swords or spears. A couple of them can't use magic. But your character can use everything.
Well, look at it this way. You said that you're leveling up characters, and chances are at some point maybe you'll start this game over. Wouldn't it be nice if those combos were just saved on your system so that when you do start unlock skills, they're just ready to go?
Well, I'm not gonna... See, I don't know how it works, but there is a rebirth system in this game. Kind of like Call of Duty Prestige mode. When you reach X level, then you can kind of restart from level 1.
Mm-hmm.
And earn your way through, but keep your skills and stuff. And you can do that in this game up to 4 times on your character. So you can almost pretty much, from what I understand, get every skill on your character that is in the game.
I was reading on the in-game message boards that when you play the... like, after you beat the story mode, it has, like, the game plus mode.
Yeah, new game plus.
That everything is still like level 1 and stuff, so if you keep your guy at like level 40 or whatever, you don't get experience for like the first 3 quarters of the game. But the items and stuff from the chests are all stuff that you need for guild rank 7 and higher quests. So it really just starts to tie all together with the online. Which is why it's insane that all the reviews haven't touched the online. It's like...
Right, like, the single player is not the driving focus of this game. It really isn't.
No.
It's almost like you need 2 separate reviews. Or at least something tied together a little bit more.
Yeah, no, yeah, I think it's the opposite. I think you have to do both in one review. Because it's like, the online is so tied into the single player, and... And the single player is also tied, or the, you know, and vice versa, I guess is what I'm trying to say.
Right.
You know, it becomes all about building up your town, synthesizing weapons and stuff like that. And a lot of that you do online, but a lot of that you have to do offline also. And you have to sort of be pretty proficient at playing offline and playing online to get the highest rank stuff and to get the rarest items and... So for a reviewer to say that they didn't bother with the online, it's not even just like they didn't play a mode, it's like they missed half the game.
Wait, did we go in a big circle?
I don't know, I'm following you, Captain.
Well, why didn't you guys look at the map to see where they...
Because my character doesn't read maps, Josh. I see your point more. Do you think, though, that maybe it just kind of comes down to this game exemplifies that a lot of reviewers don't really put the time into games that they need to give it a fair score, or at least opinion?
Yeah.
Because how could you, in a review for this game, how could you really say I didn't touch the online?
Well, the reason for that is everyone raced to be first, and they turned the servers on, like, I think 2 days before the game came out.
Yeah.
So instead of being responsible and releasing the review when the person was done, they just reviewed like, okay, we played the single player, let's just review it like that instead.
Yeah, but there's so many games where like I'll notice like when there's a big week, games come out, you know, or reviews come out like a week later. Well, didn't this come out the week of BioShock? Couldn't it have just waited a week?
Oh, ish. An elevator.
Does it work?
Yeah. Stop doing that. You bastards.
I need withered branches.
Oh my god. I shouldn't have told you guys that, about that stuff.
Well, I knew but, about this stuff.
No, they definitely should have really covered the online in this game because, it, like Pete said, it is so tied into the actual game itself. Like, really, the single player for this game is the driving factor for the online. There is no other way to say it. It is the driving factor for the online.
Yeah.
Or the Yeah.
Peach, your girlfriend's calling me. Or your fiance.
She's calling you?
I'm gonna ignore it.
she just texted me.
We're doing a podcast and I'm playing your midget right now.
Yeah, she's mad because I hit on one of her friends.
Ooh, trouble. And the podcast shifts. Let's hear the story about
that. No, but
that.
I did it on Twitter. It wasn't like...
Oh, well, that doesn't count.
Yeah,
it's text.
Yeah, I just told this girl that I would have sex with her if she wanted.
Did you come down the elevator?
No, I missed the elevator.
You want to go back and send it back up? I'll stay down here and fight these by myself. But, like, my friend Dave... I've been trying to get him to get this game because mm-hmm. I think he would love it online. And he told me, oh no, I didn't get it because IGN's review is so bad for it. They said it's a really terrible game.
I did see that, yeah.
And I was like, are you fucking kidding me, dude? Like, ignore the review. If you read the review, they outright said we didn't give the game a fucking chance. I mean, yeah. In a way they did, because they admitted we didn't try the Georama, we didn't try the online. So you didn't give the game a chance. Basically, you have no right to even like put a score on that game.
It's true.
I mean, if I had to give this game a score, I would probably give it like an 8.
Yeah.
I'd go like 7 somewhere.
I mean, the story is really bland, although where I'm at, it's really picking up. But you can't base this off the single player. It's not a single player game. It really isn't.
Seem like one of the guys that would want to use the whole scale, though. I think there should be a lot more games in the 5s. Much less in the 7s and very, very few above 8 or 9, you know what I mean?
Alright, I'll give your character a 5 and the game an 8.
Dude, you know my character's hot. Don't lie. With that lazy eye, it's awesome.
Watch this combo. Bam.
Pretty sure you're up that dude's ass right now.
228 damage.
I'm jumping up and macing him in the, Look at that dude. Metal spike he has hanging where his penis would be. That's kind of Dante's Inferno-ish.
If your character goes to jump up and hit him somewhere, it's going to be his fucking toe.
My character is quite true. Small.
Well, one thing I was telling Pete, Josh, I don't know, I think it was Pete, that this game does kind of spark my interest a little bit for like Monster Hunter, which I've never played, because I think they're bringing it to a console in some fashion. I mean, have you played that? Is this something kind of like that?
I've played it a little bit on the PSP, and this is very much like it.
Yeah. The combat in Monster Hunter is a little bit more Demon Souls-ish.
Yeah.
Which I don't think is a bad thing.
No, it's not a bad thing at all.
But I really like the combat in this, too.
Yeah.
I mean, the combat in this isn't as drawn out as people make it out to be. It is really... quite involved, especially with your combos and so forth. Ooh, there's another one over here. I'm gonna get it before you guys get here.
So, has anyone figured out why this kid's hanging around? Is he looking for like a home or something? Family?
We have to like go get the other one.
He's staying with you, Josh.
I know, because I'm awesome. I
like how you guys are mining for treasure and there's like 12 enemies up this path.
Well, go fight them.
Yeah, that's gonna work out well.
You with 100.
Some fire.
50 damage.
Yeah, my most powerful spell is like you dropping your sword.
Well, I admit it, I did kind of grind a little bit when I first got the game.
A little bit?
I didn't
do
that much.
You didn't use any skill points until like level 18.
Yeah, I didn't have to.
Yeah.
But I only really did about an hour's worth of grinding. And really, all I did was just put on music and run around and kill shit in the field that you start in. Like, grinding in this game did not feel all that bad to me.
Yeah, it's not terrible.
And I have a thing with JRPGs where I always have to run, try to find chests that are out in the wilderness.
Yeah.
So
man chests?
It just kind of worked out for me like that.
So is this the only game you've been playing then, Josh? Is this, like, consumed you right now?
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, I've played a little bit of Darksiders, which, I don't know, I wasn't going to talk about until Kyle is back for the next show, but...
Is Kyle coming back?
Maybe.
Oh, fancy?
No.
I'm confused.
Mark the time.
No, alright, I'll come out in the open with that. Kyle and I joked on Twitter saying that I kicked him off the show, and everybody seemed to have bought into it.
I bought into it. I thought you were dead serious.
And no, it was not completely serious at all. Kyle is right now, he's in Philadelphia. That's why he couldn't do the podcast.
Oh, you're a snitch. I hate your face.
I had Billy all week saying, dude, you need to talk to Kyle. Like, I can't imagine the show without either of you.
Well, I was. You seemed quite serious.
Oh, because I asked Kyle, should I go on with this? And he's like, maybe, and then in quotations, yes. So I was like, alright, I'm going to make people believe it. And so I put out that post, Critical Strike Incorporated is looking for a new co-host, Must Love Maple Syrup.
Which was actually pretty funny.
And that's, I guess, when it began, and people were asking me about it. And I never really, like, other than to you, I never said that Kyle was gone, 100%.
Yeah, that's true.
But I wanted to take the opportunity to fuck with you.
Yeah, I thought you were dead serious, man. That was a pretty good one. Because we weren't going to let you quit. We were going to force you to come be on our podcast if you were going to be a bitch and quit.
No, but Kyle will be back next week.
Well, that's good. That makes me happy that you didn't wreck a friendship.
Next episode, I should say.
If this is even a Critical Strike episode, because I imagine most people who started listening have quit by now, because it's probably horribly boring listening to us play a really nerdy game.
Well, we're talking about the game.
That's true.
We're giving a lot of insight into it. Like, we're giving more than fucking IGN gave it.
Well, it's not particularly difficult.
And, you know, I'm going to be playing the music in the background so people get to feel like they're in it. But,
yeah, probably not.
This is something, actually, we've always wanted to try on the show, though, is, like, when a big game comes out that we all love, just play and shoot the shit about it. It might not be, like, a major episode or anything, but you're playing the game, talking about it.
Don't leave me. I'm still mining for ore.
I'm fighting a basilisk.
I'll take the spider.
Well, right. Touche for tricking me, but I am glad that Kyle... I'm glad you guys didn't have some sort of falling out.
No, we wouldn't. I love Kyle. He's one of the greatest guys in the world. I actually have to talk about that later for some of the iTunes reviews that we got.
Yeah.
But, no. I mean,
so you completely quit playing Darksiders then? You're over it?
No, I'm not over it.
I thought you had sent it back already. Didn't you tweet that last week that you were...
I was going to, and then I forgot about it. And it's still right next to me.
Mm-hmm.
And same with the Gamefly White Knight Chronicles that they sent me. Because I wanted it the day that it came out, or as soon as I can get it. So I put it on Gamefly and ordered it from Amazon, hoping that I can get it.
You're a jackass. Really?
So some poor person out there is like, oh man, I wish I can get White Knight Chronicles, and here I am with two copies of it.
He'd been listening to this podcast, waiting for his Gamefly, and now he's deleting the podcast from his iTunes because you're the reason he didn't get it.
There's a note on his dresser. Dear Mom, I committed suicide because I could not play White Knight Chronicles. Seppuku has been committed. And then he's sitting there, kneeled over his bed with a fucking sword in his stomach. Poor kid. This game is worth it, though. I would definitely recommend it to almost anybody out there who loves...
It's worth suicide?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you don't have this game yet, you should definitely kill yourself.
There you go. It's a good way of putting it. Well, there's people out there who, based off of screenshots, are just refusing to play it, and I can't stand that.
I don't get that, because the screenshots, I think, look fine.
Yeah. I don't understand why people are refusing to play this. And there's people actually that are playing it that I would never have expected to play it, like CJ from the Player One podcast.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's liking it quite a bit. Though he's one of the people that said that it's not very good looking.
Yeah, he said that to me the other night.
Yeah.
And I was like, I almost replied with, you're dumb. But I didn't.
That doesn't
make
any sense to me at all.
It's not a bad looking game, but like I said, look at the perspective of what they're fitting in. I mean, you're in a gigantic map, and it's got to be scaled back a little bit, but for a console game this big, it looks really good.
That's kind of how I felt about Operation Flashpoint, though. The graphics aren't, they're by no means phenomenal, but you're playing on such a huge open area.
Right.
That I sacrifice a lot just to have that kind of free reign over whatever I want to do.
And I sacrifice Jedburgh.
Fuck Jedburgh.
There's another one over here. That's right, I'm covering it so you guys can't get it. Oh no, Pete got it. Ah, oh, dude, that's not right. You're posing over my guy's ass.
Yeah, you like that? Hmm.
But too, so, like,
do we have any idea what we're doing right now besides rambling on about this dungeon?
Because
I'm just following you.
I've never done this quest.
It's kind of one of those things, again, where I say I wish all games had waypoints that you could just set, or a better direction of where you were going.
Well, if you look at it, though, like, this game does have a really good direction. There's always, like, a star on the map of where your objective is.
Except for right now.
I haven't looked at it.
There's not.
Let me kill this monster and then look.
I'm just following your sense of direction.
There's another elevator coming up.
Yeah, I think the point of this quest is to be lost. I mean, I would think that any of the quests that take place in this tunnel system, because it is a giant maze.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And who cares? You're getting experience either way.
Yeah.
That's true.
Yeah, even if we don't finish the quest, it's like we got a ton of resources and experience.
Which you can use.
I hate you.
Hey, I'm not the one that stopped playing. Like, that's another thing, too.
I didn't,
like,
stop playing. I have a lot of things going on.
Oh, I know. But, like, Mick stopped playing totally.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he, like, just stopped.
Well, he's going gaga for Bioshock 2.
Yeah, that's true.
That doesn't make sense to me.
Wait a goddamn minute.
Huh. This looks a lot like where we started, leader.
Well, we probably have to go back to where we started and return this kid, don't we?
I went, when we went up to the person, he said something and totally blew me off. I was like, go fuck yourself. But there is no star on the map telling me where we have to go. We went and got the kid.
Are you sure we're not supposed to kill the kid?
supposed to eat the kid.
Supposed to sacrifice him to the midget and the black guy.
But there are quite a few games out right now, too, in Mix or anyone's defense. I mean, I'm in your camp, Josh, where I was playing a bunch of stuff, including Darksiders, which I love, and...
Yeah.
And Mag, which I kind of like, but since I've gotten into this game, it's pretty much the only thing I've put in my PlayStation.
That's a cool looking spell.
Mm-hmm. So Mag, you're just kind of lukewarm on?
Yeah. I mean, it's growing on me as I level and get to do the bigger fights and whatnot, but it's still, I don't know. There's nothing special about it. Other than the player count. But the player count doesn't... is really... I mean, it's more than a gimmick, but it just sort of feels like a gimmick. Because it's not like you're ever fighting 256 players at the same time. Right. You're typically in, like, one-on-one or, like, two-on-two shootouts. So whether there's 256 players in the whole map or not doesn't particularly matter.
I know... Paul from the Video Game Jocks was talking about it, and he said that Mag was rubbish.
Really?
Well, they are pretty hardcore Xbox fanboys.
I don't know where the fuck we're supposed to go right now, but I think I'm going to go back to that person at the front of the entrance.
We have to wait for short stuff.
I'm going without you guys.
I fucking hate you.
Bye!
Damn it. I'm all alone. What if a troll comes?
They won't trust me. And then one spawns on me. That actually happened to me. I couldn't believe that it happened. I was sitting there just chilling out. I loaded the game and I was kind of grinding a little bit. And I put down my controller and 2 minutes later I looked at the screen and a bunch of things spawned on top of me. So, like, as you're killing things in the world, it does respawn.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool.
You know, I think you should start some sort of PayPal drive on your website through your podcast where everyone can chip in money so that Kyle can get a PlayStation. I'll throw in like 15, 20 bucks.
You know, I've tried to get him to buy one and he just won't. Like, he won't.
Because it would be fun having Kyle here so he could go, this is gay, that's dumb, this is terrible.
I think he would really like this game, actually. This is like up his alley.
He just wouldn't like the spiders or my character.
Why wouldn't he like? Oh, yeah, that's true. I haven't played online with anybody else too, like, except for like you guys and Meg. Like, there's a bunch of people on my friends list. Like, the community is quite large.
Yeah, I've actually been surprised with my friends list, which ranges from the Fanboys forums, the Player One podcast forums, and my SOCOM clan. And mm-hmm. people from all three of those groups have this game. And the SOCOM clan is the one that's the most surprising. I have like four guys in my SOCOM clan that picked this up.
Huh.
So it's selling well, at least to hardcore gamers. You know, I don't expect it to chart or anything.
No. Well, Demon Souls sold well too, but
yeah.
It didn't. But they're saying that this is supposed to be like a trilogy.
Yeah, but has it done well enough to necessitate the second one?
In Japan, I don't think it did well at all. It came out, and it was a piece of crap when it came out in Japan. Luckily for the American and Europe versions, they incorporated all the fixes and changes.
Yeah. I think that Level 5 as a developer, though, has enough... I don't know what the word is, but... If they want to make a second one, Sony would be like, okay.
Yeah.
You know, if they're like, well, we'll get it right this time. You know, and not that there's anything wrong with this game, but they'll, you know, market it better or, you know, have it stronger at release.
Well, like, there's people out there, like, Mick, too, is one of them. He said, anything by Level 5, I'm buying.
Yeah.
And I'm definitely one of those people. So, like, if they did another one, I'd be all over it. I just kind of want to get to the point where we can do some of the later quests, because when I saw, they look really cool, and you fight some crazy monsters.
Yeah, I'm really excited about the sort of endgame stuff with this game. It seems very complex with having to gather the materials and leveling up your town and all of that stuff just to get the loot. It's not like your typical PSO or even World of Warcraft where you go down, you know, a one-way tunnel, and then at the end there's a boss, you kill it, and it gives you loot. Like, this game, you really kind of have to work at a bunch of different stuff, which is neat. You know, it's a very hardcore game. I mean, which I guess is sort of the JRPG trademark, which is why people like Billy are...
cautious.
Dumb.
Yeah.
God damn it.
Well, I mean, Billy and I discussed this the other night, but he and I are like... polar opposites when it comes to games of what we like.
Mm-hmm.
He's like your Western guy. He loves your BioWare games and your shooter games, your realistic shooters, I should say. Whereas, like, give me my goofy JRPGs and I'm happy.
Yeah, you do like the teenage boy saving the world.
I do. It's enjoyable to me. I don't know why.
I'm just saying.
Hey, there's a bridge that we haven't been over yet.
Hey, you maybe do know where you're going. Cool.
And another elevator.
I kind of remember that bridge.
Oh, I'm going without you guys again.
No. Oh, you left a kid. Haha. I'm going to kill him and push him into the mine shaft.
No, he just came up here with me.
I fucking hate you.
Quest will end in 15 minutes.
Oh, shit.
They give you long time for quests, too.
Obviously not long enough.
Not kidding.
So, I don't know. Have we said all that we need to say, or is there anything more?
I think we can recap that the reviews are stupid for the 50th time. Just in case people don't get it yet, the reviews are really bad.
I don't know if I could tell someone to buy it, but I definitely say try it.
Will you guys get up here? I'm under attack.
That's what you get, fancy boy.
Look, I have my Buster Sword, that's all I need. And my big spiked armor. But I guess I should mention the iTunes reviews that we've gotten as of late, since it seems like we're going to be wrapping this up.
You should probably splice that in at the beginning.
What?
If you're going to talk about the iTunes reviews.
Why?
Because I don't know how many people have made it through our quest.
Fuck them. they'll listen. Everybody wants to hear about this great game that nobody's playing, that more people should play. Anyways, we did get some iTunes reviews. One from Hammer of God, a.k.a. Paul, from the illustrious Video Game Jocks. He called Billy stupid, and we appreciate it.
I don't think he called me stupid. Wasn't it Kyle?
No, he called you.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Cool.
He's like, that guy, Billy, he's stupid.
And I'm not sure gonna leave us a review and say that. I don't think we have any reviews, do we?
Really?
I don't know.
I've never checked. Maybe we do.
I'll delete you guys.
We have 14 fuck offs.
Haven't left us a review.
I've gotten two friends requests today from people who have put in the message that they were listeners, though.
Oh, really?
Cool. Yeah.
So that's exciting.
Right on. The other review that we got was from JD Blackbox. We appreciate it. So he's a friend of a friend through the Gamer Husbands podcast. They're good. Check them out. I like it. And the other one, it's kind of weird doing this without Kyle. I feel kind of strange.
Well, there was one that called Kyle a bully, wasn't there?
And that's the one I was going to mention, but yeah, that's from Outlaw Moogle, or Outlaws, as he is on Twitter. And he said that I'm a very insightful, nice guy, blah, blah, blah. And Kyle is a nerdy bully.
Which I don't get, because I think you're much meaner to Kyle.
No.
Oh, you are.
No. But I do have to say, if you go back and listen to the older shows, Kyle and I tend to push each other's buttons a lot. We tend to know what pisses each other off, and we tend to occasionally do it. And Kyle is in no way a bully. He's actually like one of the sweetest guys you can know. Like, there's nothing that he wouldn't do for a friend. So I just wanted to make it out there that he's not a bully. He's a great guy. And he is nerdy, though. I can't defend that one. I mean, the day that we sat here talking on Skype with Billy and Rich, and he's trying to form his, like, Dungeons & Dragons stuff or whatever it was.
I forgot about that.
Like, we're trying to hold a conversation with him, and he's like, oh, man.
I broke the skull spear. Damn it.
Oh, I leveled up again.
Rats.
Look at that, 24.
I love how you just break out of this, you know, deep-hearted admiration of Kyle for, I leveled up.
So basically, I pulled a Kyle.
Yeah. The story you were trying to tell was just proven by example.
Yeah. No, we were shooting the shit on Skype, which, by the way, we haven't done our Saturday night Critical Strike Fest.
We're doing it right now, dickface.
That's true. Yeah.
And if you ever quit, you know, you could finish your thought on Kyle.
My thought on Kyle is he's a sweet guy. He's fun. He's smart.
Talk about his eyes.
He has very dreamy eyes. And he's Canadian. I mean, what more can you ask for?
That's true.
See, that right there is something that where we push each other's buttons. In case you haven't realized, he's not really Canadian.
You know another great thing about Kyle?
What's that?
He probably wouldn't lead us to dead ends and make us fail this quest because he doesn't know where he's going.
Look, there's no objective on the map.
Whoa, what was that?
That was me being awesome. Dude, this is some sick AoE.
That's eruption.
You need to respect Radio. Your character, Billy.
Well, I'm glad that we were part of your first and most likely last game playthrough podcast.
Right? Well, it's just kind of something to fit in, because, like, you always mentioned that if Kyle's not around, we tend to not do a podcast. Or if I'm not around, we just won't even bother.
That's true.
And this is kind of like a way to kind of break that, maybe.
Yeah, I think the next one, we should fire up some Borderlands.
You know, you had me at Fire Up, and then you lost me at Borderlands.
Yeah.
It's not gonna happen.
Yeah. No, there'll be some things to play later. Has anyone figured out how many players you can play online with the baseball game? Is it just two?
MLB?
Yeah, it's just two.
It'd be cool if it was four, so I could just stand on the outfield and bitch at Kyle for throwing bad pitches.
Well, Kyle doesn't have a PS3. How can he play it?
He's going to get one.
No, he's not.
Going to start a PS3 drive on your website.
Look, you guys start a Kyle PS3 drive, and
yeah, I don't think it's going to turn out well if we do it.
I'll take the money.
No.
And then I'll go buy some blue.
I would hate to see you on cocaine.
Yeah.
Bye, guys. Wouldn't be good, I don't think.
And I guess that's going to wrap it up, because really, we've beaten this down quite a bit. So we'll see you guys in 2 weeks. Sorry for the boring show about White Knight Chronicles. Buy the game or Pete will kill you.
Yeah. No, they should already be dead. if that bought
That's right. We established that if you don't have the game already, you need to write a note to your mom and then die.
Well, kill yourself.
So thank you for listening. We'll see you in 2 weeks.
PSNerds.com.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Sorry. Check out the PS Nerds. Billy's been on. You already know of them. I mean, really, if you listen to us at this point, you're probably listening to them.
Yeah. You'll have to have Pete back on when it's not, like, such a boring game-focused podcast.
This is not, game is not boring!
It is to listen to.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'm don't know. I've listened to some pretty terrible podcasts all the way through.
I mean, all this Mass Effect stuff as of late has been putting me to sleep.
I try to keep it short.
No.
I have Mass Effect waiting for me at home.
Oh, Cornflake actually sent it?
He did.
No shit.
I like how we keep trying to wrap it up. We just go back into another...
Hey, we're back at this bridge you said we never crossed.
Yeah, but we're killing
God
a troll.
Damn it.
All right, that's it. Check out PS Nerds. Thank you for the iTunes review. Leave us some. Follow us on Twitter at Critical Strike. Omnicero on Twitter. Kyle's KR Dumond. Leave us a voicemail. The number's on the website. I'm looking it up right now. All right. Thank you and goodbye.
Bye.